Hello YouTube, welcome to OpenTTD with Lightman Joker, and we're back here near our cargo network, and I'm still looking at this, wondering whether this is the ultimate solution, but let's continue. I've written down some things that I am planning to do these few next episodes. One of them is actually to update this station layout a little bit, and I'm going to use that opportunity to show you a little bit how to get a better layout for a station going that will have a lot of trains incoming, which will be true for this one, since we will put quite a few more cargo trains on this kind of a little main line that we're developing here. So let me quickly get rid of some of these tracks so I have some room to work with. And then I'm going to try and make this a little bit more a sensible solution. There's another train coming in, but we'll have to live with that. Actually, that guy can continue coming here because I'm not going to modify much about him. The thing that you have in terminal stations as a major major downside, I would say, is that you have, well, 80 should be enough, is that you have the same track for incoming trains and for leaving trains. That's the advantage that you have in roll-on, roll-off stations, where the trains come in from one side and leave onto the other side. To fix that for terminal stations, you can come pretty close to a roll-on, roll-off by simply splitting up the tracks. And you do that by doing something like this. Let me quickly finish this layout, then I'm going to explain it to you. There we go. Now, as you can see, for incoming trains, they can choose to go either here or there to go into the station. For leaving trains, they can go here and with this one here. Once they go past this point on that track and past this point on that track, they have already made room for the next train to come in. So that means we have split tracks for incoming and leaving trains, and that gives us major performance increase. Let me quickly go ahead and we will put in a little bend into this main line right here. And what we're also going to do is making something that we did on the other tracks already. This is all a little tight, but for our purposes, with these still slow trains, this should actually be enough, but I should probably widen this a little bit. So they have a little bit more of a passing opportunity here, since there's going to be a train waiting here and another train waiting there. Now the incoming trains have to decide here where they want to go, and you shouldn't put a signal past this point. You can have this kind of layout with more platforms. You should put a signal working with the pass signals. It's different with these ones, but as I told you, you shouldn't actually use these. Just use these two. It's easier with those. Put a pass signal before the first split, because if you put one, because that's where trains decide where they want to go. If you put one beyond that, they will actually see already that there is a free path. Let's say you put one here and the train is trying to go in here. Once he passes that signal, this little part of the track is being considered empty. So a train might actually decide here to go in there. It will have to stop here because, well, the platform is full, but this part was empty, so it was fine to proceed until there. You don't want that. You want them to wait here for the first platform to go. If they go past this point already deciding for one side, they will no longer have the possibility to choose one of these on the other side if one is clearing up. The path signals only look for a free path. You don't have to worry about incoming trains from other direction. As long as their paths on the tracks don't actually intersect, it doesn't matter how many signals are in front here. They will just consider the track that they track pieces that they will actually use. So you only need a signal here. On the back direction, you can pretty much put as many signals as you want, except here, of course, you can't put a one-way signal. Otherwise, these signals on the back tracking are just there to enable the trains to indicate already when the next one behind them should be able to follow up. I don't want them to wait in certain places, however, like I don't want them to wait here because it would actually block the path for trains going over here. Now also a little bit about where it is actually safe to let trains wait. You should think about a point where you have a crossing like this, a junction. If a train actually waits blocking that junction, what would be the problem doing that? Let's say, for example, I'm putting a signal right here, pointing up. Then a train could be waiting here. Being long enough, it would block this junction. Would that be bad? Well, no, because blocking this junction will block trains coming from here and trains coming from here. You should ask yourself, if it wasn't blocking, would I be in a better point than if it was blocking? Well, what would happen if it didn't block there? Could anybody proceed? Well, no, because why is it blocking this? Because it cannot proceed because something is in front there. Well, if there is something in front there, then this guy coming from that direction could proceed either, because it also wants to go in this direction. So that is not bad. You can think of it like this. If you're blocking a junction where trains meet that all want to go in the same direction, coming from maybe different direction, but all wanting to go into the same direction, then you're not blocking anything really, because if you can't proceed in that direction, then nobody else would be able to either. Now this junction is a little bit different, because if one train actually stops here, wanting to go there, it could potentially block trains that want to go there. You potentially come from the same place, but you want to go to two different places. So only if you may not be able to proceed because this line is blocked, that doesn't mean that this line is blocked. So you shouldn't proceed until here and block that. You should wait on one of these two lines so other trains coming from one of the other lines can proceed if they want to go in a different direction. So this one I don't want to be blocked. This one I can have blocking. I can easily put another signal in here. That is no big deal, because here only trains can meet that all want to go in the same direction. Here trains can meet that want to go in different directions. And you can see this is a merge, this is a split. In general, you can always block a merge. You should never ever block a split. There are some occasions where that is also okay, but in this case, especially in these kinds of junctions, a split should never be blocked. So always have enough room, as I told you already in earlier videos, have enough room after a split so an entire train can fit in there without blocking the actual split. That's why I won't, for example, put a signal here. So let's see, do we have enough signals in here? Let's put another one in there. Another one in there, and that should be fine. So now we can allow these trains to go in again. Now let me quickly speed this up so you can see what is actually happening here once these guys come in and arrive. Now as you can see, this guy is leaving and he's not blocking this one. This guy didn't have to stop for going in there. As you can see these, they're passing each other. One is leaving and the other one is coming in. If you had this cross here in the middle, the leaving drain would block the entire cross, so nobody could come in. See? These immediately crossed themselves and nobody was blocking the other one. That's the advantage of this way of station layout. You can extend this to a four platform layout, and I might actually do that later on. But for now, for the amount of trains that we have here, this is fine. And of course, these very, very sharp curves are not fine. But with trains that don't do more than 60 anyway, since their cars cannot go faster than 60, we're not really in a lot of trouble, because no curve, except maybe a 90 degree curve, which I forbid trains from taking anyway, just for information, that would be if this small piece here wasn't there and this bridge would immediately go into that direction. Like if I did stuff like this, a train could come in here and immediately go into the other direction. Like such a cross, with my settings, a train cannot go from one of these lines to the other one, because 90 degree turns are forbidden. Those could slow my trains down, I think, but since those are forbidden, even these very sharp turns cannot slow them down more than the 60 that they're only able to do anyway. So that is for a while all I'm going to do here. I will put a lot more trains on these lines, but not right now, because I have some plans up here at our passenger network. One thing that I'm also going to do, by the way, is go for all of our city buses, and I'm going to change their orders, or rather their timetable. And I'm only going to do one little change. And you may wonder, why the hell are you doing that? Well, those are city buses, and it would be very unrealistic for city buses, which are by definition only operating inside the city, to go past 50 kilometers per hour, since we're in Germany here. And I don't know what city speed limits are in other countries. From what I know, most in the European Union, they should be exactly the same. In the United States, probably something similar, although they probably chose a miles per hour number that is actually a round number, a round figure. But it should be something very similar. So that is what I'm going to change here. This is just a little bit of role playing. Nothing that you have to worry about in your game, of course. But I thought it might be a little bit more realistic. This also indicates, of course, that I will never need any bus that does more than 50 kilometers per hour inside a city, because I'm not going to allow them to go faster than that anyway. Which also may make some vehicles actually more useful inside the cities, because it's not always the fastest bus that you want. I also see here, by the way, that a lot of these buses become very old, so we might actually want to replace some of them real soon. I have to check why they are also very old by now, because we're only playing 10 years, and I thought these guys would at least... Whoa, what the hell is this? Good that I looked at this. Let me quickly check what's going on here. Central Heights. Well, I'm considering this to be... that this should be that, and that should be... that? Why is that an invalid order? Why the hell did they have invalid orders here? If someone spotted this in one of the videos, please let me know, because I would like to see what the hell went wrong there. That is really strange. Actually, let me quickly check whether I didn't... Yes, they should go into the other direction, and they are going the other direction, okay. That was a little strange, because these guys go to the exact same places, they just do it in the other direction. And if they are fine, the other ones should also be fine. So that is a little curious. Sorry, by the way, I noticed a little bit in the videos that most people are actually skipping this kind of stuff when I'm doing this kind of micromanagement. Now, we could, of course, speed this stuff up, but, well, first of all, you are able to skip it, and second of all, it is part of the game. This is what you will spend a lot of time with, so... But we're fine now. Where is actually our tram? There we go. I also noticed I didn't give these guys some names, so let's do that right off. Only four, so not going to pause the recording for that. And we're done after this with most of what I wanted to adjust on this side. All there. So let me quickly check. Yes, all of them have names. So now about actually making them, turning them into new vehicles, because they're old. I also wanted to turn off auto renew, because I don't want the game to automatically replace them, because I wanted to check which ones are actually, let me quickly save this, which ones are actually old and what I want to replace them with. But I'm still going to let them run for a while. They seem to be fine so far. What I want to do first here, we quickly go through my notes here. Maybe I have something else to go on. By the way, someone told me I should repay the loan. I will do that soon. I need the money right now for some bigger project that I have in mind. But once that is finished and some more money is going in, also after I have extended our cargo network down there, well, not the network, put more trains on it, there will be a lot of money coming in, and that's when I'm going to repay the loan. But thanks for the reminder. I will keep that in mind. So, no, I don't have anything in my notes. What I have in mind is, now that we have 1930 already, it is kind of time to put our first express train and even a premium train on the tracks. I'm going to put an express train going from Frankfurt, Zwickau, to Schifferstadt, going past these smaller cities, these smaller towns, which are not important. For that, I'm going to need a high-speed track going past these smaller ones. Because remember, this is an 80 km per hour track. I will have a faster train going there, so I need better track on that. But something else that I want to get going right now, because that actually will be part of what I'm planning to do next, is extending the two main stations of Heilbronn and Günzburg, because that's where my premium train will go, and we will go with that premium train all the way down to these three cities. So let's get going on that. And I'm going to use the track planning tracks because those will be cheaper, and this is going to be quite a bit of planning work that I have to do here. So let's first extend these tracks in that direction. I'm not going to extend them further in that direction because that's actually where something is going to change as well. And I'm going to keep some distance here because I can't have two different kinds of tracks on one tile, I believe. That's a little limitation of the game still. Oh, I actually need to do this. No, let me get rid of that. Because I come down... Where do I actually come from? I come from here. I'm actually move this one further to the side. What? Oh yes, that out there I would already be on that track. So let me get rid of this one. And let me put in this one. No, you stupid thing. Remove that one. Track here, so I have some more room to put the track planning in, because I want that right here. There we go. So that is our planned track. It will go all the way past here. And then we'll go past there. Going to have to actually switch these lines here. I'm going to have to work later on switching here actually, because one time I go past the station on one side and then I go past the station on the other side, and here it is the same again. That I will have to work with once I get this going, and I have to think about how I want to do that. Otherwise, let's just get the track in place for now. Here, this is a little bit tricky. So we can actually have a split here that works. Yes, that should be fine. And there we go again. This time we're on the other side again, so... So that will be a little bit tricky. Now I only plan it up till here, because from that point on I will actually have to work a little bit on getting that changed up there. But I can put them still in the right track, yes. I can finish that here. This one will also change a little bit. This one will actually become a four tile train station, because I want to extend our trains to become four long. Well, not these ones, but the express trains that I'm going to do. Those are going to be four long. actually working on my laptop here in parallel, so I have my stopwatch going. Okay, this one will be a little bit tricky because here I'm going to plan to actually have... How long is this? This is already a 5 station, okay. Here I'm planning to have a little bit of a special station going on. Sorry for talking a little bit away from you. I have to look at a little picture of the station that I'm planning to do here. How do I want to do this? Let me quickly work with the rail already here because I need to. Work a little bit on a little tweaky thing here. You've probably never seen this station layout before because I've never seen it before either. This is a little station that is, well, kind of a tricky kind of station because it pretty much allows trains to come in from both sides. So from this direction and from this direction, but they will also enter the station both from the same direction, which sounds a little bit confusing, but once you see the thing, it will become clear, trust me. At least I hope it will. Sorry for being a little quiet, but here I have to be really concentrated on how I make this station. Okay, here we need the most expensive one because we need that high speed. And that actually doesn't work. Sorry. Need to put the bridge up here. There we go. Okay. I want something to be put in here. In there, and I probably want another one right over here. Can we have one right over here? I don't know whether these guys can actually enter it then. Probably not. Let me quickly check something. Can I trick here? Can I play a trick here? No, can't play a trick there. Maybe if I do it like this. This looks very, very funny and very confusing. But the point behind this is now, this should be enough for now. The point behind this is that you can have trains coming from here. This one will actually go away. That you can have trains coming from these directions and going up in there, and actually removed vital piece now. I'm such an idiot. This actually had to stay. There we go. Well, this guy's completely confused, so give him something to go to. There we go, so he can actually turn around again. Now, the trains will come up here. Or from here, coming from the other direction. And they will all enter here. Whether they come from there or down here, they will all enter in here. If they want to go back up there, they will simply go around and up here. And if they want to go this direction, they will come down here. I hope this is somewhat clear what the hell is actually happening here. I hope. I'm choosing this design because it is actually pretty space, pretty conservative on the space that it is using. Sorry, it's hard to speak and concentrate at the same time. But maybe you can see what's going on here. So this will actually become all bidirectional. And I will probably add another track in here later. But for now, yes, I cannot put that in there because I have track in parallel that is of a different type. Go. But this should work now. And of course we need signals for all the platforms. We don't need one for the depot, that works automatically, as I've mentioned quite a few times. And then we're just going to put in new platforms. Actually, look here, what do we have? Well, let's just put in the standard ones. Oh yes, I probably need to convert these first. The kind of track that I'm using. Cannot build railway station there, of course not, because I want that one. Okay, there we go. Now we have a nice little station here where trains can come in from up there and choose one of the platforms, and where they can also leave from one of the platforms and go in both directions. Both coming in and going out. Now the express train line that I want to go is actually a line that I want to go parallel to this one, because I don't want the express trains going through this station, of course. that station will not exactly be making sure that our train is going to be very fast. See, this is why you use planning track. So you don't build all this stuff for nothing, spending a lot of money. You get some money back when you destroy it again, but I don't actually know whether that is the full amount. There we go. That's what we wanted. And this one we're going to link up right for this one. So we'll have a little junction right there. Actually, we'll have the junction right here, probably. Yes. As you can see, I can't put it there because it's the same kind of track. Let me actually remove that and build that right away, that part. Even though it is the wrong speed type right now. I don't want this piece right there. I want it there. And I have a little junction right there. Okay. So that's our little express line up until there. So let's extend it to where we actually want to go. Here we're actually going to extend it right there because that train is going to use that part of the line. You actually see where the thing has built already. That's a little bit annoying about this because it has, of course, the same color as the dirt because basically it is dirt. You cannot see very much of what you're actually doing until it has cleared up. So there we go. Here we want to go down a little bit, which isn't a big problem. As I told you, S-curves don't actually limit speed. Let me see where I actually need to go. Okay, here I want to leave this height level actually. Probably want to go right there through the middle. And let's see how we can meet those two up. There we go. And to go down there, I probably will to stay at this level for the initial stage. Or rather, I have to be here on this level, and I have to work with this. And here I need to make a curve, so I need to make sure this curve isn't as sharp, and that is my stopwatch. Sorry, should probably have turned that sound off. But we're going to finish at least the planning, I would say. The station is going to be a four-track station right through here. Which means I will... Well, four track is actually not possible, so we have to put in a two track station. But we will make it a very... putting in three tracks anyway, because I'm planning to have three tracks there in the future. So I want to reserve these already. But for now, let's try and make this curve as smooth as possible, so we don't have a lot of speed loss here. go. So we should be able to put the station somewhere right in there. And actually, let me keep the planning tracks there for a while so they don't actually expand anything in that direction. So that is going to be what I'm planning to do. Here we have, of course, to make another S-curve again. So we go past this little point, same as here. As you can see, this is quite a big project that I'm doing here. This is going to take a little while. Also have to check whether I actually have the money to convert these right away to high-speed track. And we also have to check what our fastest train can actually do in terms of speed, so we know how far we have to upgrade it. There we go. And that is where our other line will go, coming from here. It will join up right over there, which we'll probably have to do like this, so we don't intersect with our depot there. So here the upper line will again be the high-speed track. And how do I want to actually keep my slow trains from using my high-speed track? That's going to be pretty easy, because the high-speed track will not lead to any of these smaller stations. So if they want to reach those stations, they will not be able to take these tracks. So that is our planning stage for now. We changed the speed limit of the buses, we put in the planning for all of these new kind of tracks. I haven't figured out how to change this station yet, but that comes next. I can tell you, however, already that this will also be a four-track layout. Actually, I'm a little bit disappointed that I can't put a four-track layout down there for the stations. I just can't connect them with four tracks, which isn't necessary either. So that should be fine. So we will have four-track stations at all of these places. This one I will upgrade next, and then we will actually work on getting this track, this planning track, convert into actual track. Also, we will see on where we actually extend this stuff, because I kind of want to go around this in that direction for future purposes. All that in the next episode. For now, I say keep your heads up, folks. I see you on the next one.